Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, the wait is over. It's now time for the unfinished business main event of the evening. The title of action will be for the showdown for the Quest British Middleweight Championships. So please make some noise for the challenger fighting out of Red Hill in Surrey. Please welcome Cheznie Hawkins. And now we welcome his opponent, the champion, into the arena tonight, making his first defense. Please make some noise for the Quest British Middleweight Champion, Ronnie Chisholm. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, this bout brought to you in association with RTX Sports, the official fight gloves of Quest Boxing League, BoxFit, the UK's leading box equipment superstore, and our headline sponsor, RhysMany.com. So introducing to you first the challenger, Fighting tonight out of the blue corner. He is wearing the black and purple shorts. Fighting out of Small Orleans Boxing Gym. Make some noise for Cheznie Hawkins. And standing across the ring, boxing out of the red corner tonight, wearing the red, white, and black shorts. He is representing Dennis and Dyer Boxing Academy and is the current reigning, defending Quest British Middleweight Champion, Ronnie Chisholm. Tonight's main event will be fought over 5 2-minute rounds. And now to give his final instructions and third man in the ring, Mr. Wayne Alexander.
Well, if this is not the fight that you've been waiting for, Dan, there's something wrong in this world. It's the one I've been waiting for. And we've got Cheznie Hawkins trying to take the British middleweight title from the waist of Ronnie Chisholm. Now, Ronnie, you may remember last time, absolutely blitzed Mide de Digby to become the champion. And I tell you what, he's an improving sort, isn't he?
He is, yeah. These two have met before. There's history. No bad blood, but history. Yeah. It was a close fight the last time they met. But what we've seen from Chisholm is that he's made massive improvements. So it's going to be interesting to see how this one goes. I've seen a lot from Hawkins since, like I say, what we see from Chisholm against the Degbe was unexpected. We knew he was a good fighter. We knew he'd made improvements. We didn't know he'd make that much improvement.
And he pitched him, didn't he?
He did, yeah. Is it going to be the same tonight? Is he going to be able to show us again tonight that he's got... That those improvements have continued to be made under the tutelage of Mark Dennis over there. He's a good fighter himself, a great coach. He's got a great gym over there with Dennis and Dyer Boxing Academy. Or is Cheznie Hawkins going to show us that he's to get this rematch. Yeah, he deserves this rematch. But he's got to go. He's not the champion, so he's got to go and he's got to bring the fight to Chisholm and make it his own. I think what people, when it comes to title fights, I think people have come to expect fireworks and it to explode from the first bell. This isn't one of those fights. It never was going to be one of those fights. They're both going to have a look at each other.
Yeah.
Great combination there from Cheznie Hawkins.
How interesting. What an interesting start.
Yeah, it was a great combination. It was a jab, right uppercut, and it took Chisholm off guard. Chisholm's got to shake that off. He's got to cover up and make sure that Hawkins doesn't come forward and just maraud him. Real good work here from Hawkins.
Yeah. Oh, another standing count.
Wayne Alexander's given another standing count.
Well, it is a title fight, so.
It is, yes. Yeah, he's going to allow him to try and continue. I think the bell's just gone. I think we couldn't quite hear it amongst the fuss.
How interesting. Oh, that's a massive round.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how Chisholm comes back from that. Cheznie Hawkins, brilliant shots that he put together there, and he really capitalised on the fact that he hurt Chisholm. There we were saying how much Chisholm's improved. Obviously Hawkins is as well.
10-7. Yeah, I was chatting to Mark Dennis, one of Chisholm's trainers earlier, you know, the main trainer, of course, who was a cruiserweight and heavyweight champion, you know, in this game. And, you know, he looked really cool and convinced.
Yeah.
And I mean, it may still happen.
Oh, yeah, rightly so. I mean, Chisholm's shown that he's a very good boxer, so this is even more a testament to the quality of Cheznie Hawkins, the fact that he's landing these shots on a fighter that he's a very good fighter.
I mean, I'm wondering where the Ronnie Chisholm has gone that we saw last time.
Well, he's a little bit caught in the headlights, isn't he? He's open to that right hand over the top. He's not managed to He's not managed to stop that shot coming through, the shot that landed. Yeah. And that's what he's got to do. He's got to get that left hand up and stem the flow of those right hands landing. Cheznie Hawkins is putting on a great performance here.
Yes.
He's picking his shots really well, coming up under the elbows onto the ribs of Chisholm. But Chisholm coming back now, he's trying to get himself back into this fight. But
if you remember the last time we saw him against the Digby, he just took control and that was it.
He did, yeah. And up until the eight count, he seemed in control of this fight. But obviously Cheznie Hawkins had other ideas.
Yeah, good on you, Chez. He's done very well.
He has, yeah. It's been a really good, really composed performance. This is what we like to see on Quest. We like to see a mix of action. We like to see a mix of action with good quality
boxing.
And this is exactly what we're getting here. And he's been caught with that right hand over again.
Oh, towels come in.
Towels come in.
Towels come in. Yeah. Oh. Mark. Well, Mark Dennis not happy with that. Threw the towel in.
Yeah, Chisholm's a young man. He can live to fight another day. He was working his way back into the fight, but he was still getting caught with that right hand over the top. He was shipping damage.
Yeah.
Mark Dennis is a very good fighter. He knows the game. And Chisholm is in good hands with Mark Dennis, and Mark Dennis done the right thing there by stopping that fight.
Hey, gives him another chance.
It does, yeah.
But what it does mean, of course, he's lost his British middleweight title to Cheznie Hawkins.
It does, yeah, it does.
I mean, there's every chance it'll come on again.
Yeah, of course. This is a fight that we could see as a rematch in a couple of fights' time. I just want to point out again, I just want to say that that takes a brave coach to do something like that in a title fight. He knows his fight better than anyone.
But he knows what life has been like in the last few weeks.
Exactly, yeah.
We don't know what he's been going through.
No, obviously Chisholm wasn't happy with the stoppage, but I'm pretty sure
what
when
fighter
he goes back.
Is.
It, exactly. He would have carried on until he was carried out on a stretcher, but we don't want to see that.
No.
And Mark
I
Dennis
need Mark, yes.
made a really brave, really, really good call there.
Yeah, that's good of you to say. Oh well. Well, there you are. Ronnie Chisholm wants to put the belt around the waist of the new champion. And, I'm going to say this loud and clear. The new British middleweight champion is Cheznie Hawkins.
Cheznie Hawkins, somewhat of a surprise to us, I suppose, because, like we said, we were so impressed with the way that Chisholm had progressed. But Hawkins...
You've got to ask the question, where does that put the Digby?
It's, again, styles make fights, fighters make fights.
I could use a horse racing analogy and say, oh, you were beaten by so-and-so, and he was beaten by so-and-so, but mine beat that one, so I'm better than all of them.
Yeah, yeah.
You know
what
I mean? It's tough, isn't it?
It is.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, at a time of 1 minute, 21 seconds of the second round, our referee, Mr. Wayne Alexander, stops the contest. You winner and new Quest British middleweight champion,
excellent win, and bad luck there to Ronnie Chisholm, and his dad Wayne will be very disappointed, I'm sure. But there you go, hey, life.